The first step in building a simple calculation is to invoke the wizard. And what I've done is I've invoked VB6, Microsoft's Visual Basic application, and canceled out of the new project window that appears when you start the application up. And what I'm going to do is go in under the add-ins and select Ace Wizard and New. And what this is going to do is bring up something that's going to allow me to define the Pi server, an executable name, and a class module name. I will call the executable name my Ace Calcs, and I will refer to the first calculation module that I'm going to create as first calc. And I will click Next. Once you get the name defined for your calculation, you need to select the inputs and outputs for your calculation. Now for the inputs, you can either select tag names using a tag search, or if you have aliases defined in your module database, you can select alias search. We'll look at that a little bit later. I'm going to select a tag for my input, so I'll click under tag name and then click tag search. And I have a tag that begins with the letters BA on my system. It's a temperature tag, and I'm going to use that one as an example. Let's say that this temperature tag is being recorded in degrees Celsius, and I want to know what the tag is in degrees Fahrenheit. So what I will do is I will leave the BA temp 1 as my input and go to my output. Now, the problem I have here is that my output tag does not exist yet. So what I need to do is create a tag, but you don't need to leave the application to do that. That's the one nice thing about ACE. I can click Configure Tag, and I can build a tag right on my system. And I will use the same naming convention as the original tag, except I will use the extension _FH as my tag, so I know that's my Fahrenheit tag. Select 0 and span if I would like to change those. And my compression deviation, I'm going to change to 0. I will click Create, and I will create a new tag. I change the compression deviation to 0 simply because every time I generate a value, I want to keep it. I don't want anything compressed. So I've got my new tag, and I can close my dialog box, and you can see the output tag has been initiated or created in the system, and my current value for that tag is point created. If there were multiple tags I was going to use in the calculation, I would simply come to the input aliases and use my mouse to define new tags and put more tags into the tag list here. If my output calculation had more than one result, or I had different results in my calculation, then I would select more tags for my output aliases. We'll explain clamping and bad value substitution in a little while. Once you've completed the two steps in the wizard, you will be placed into the code base of your calculation. Now you need to notice two very important things here. First is that there's a lot of code here already generated, and all of this code is the source code required for the compiled application to function correctly. ACE has done all that for you. You don't have to enter in any of that information, and that's why we say you don't have to be a programmer in order to use ACE. The other thing that has happened here, and this is actually very key to what you're going to do next, is that ACE has come up with a conversion or a correspondence table, because the tag names that we have in the Pi system, the naming conventions are much less restrictive than the Visual Basic rules for variables. For example, I'm not allowed to use colons or periods. And so in order for Visual Basic not to have a problem with that, we need to define some variables that Visual Basic can work with. And you can see that it's slightly renamed using underscores, our tag names. You will need to use these VB variable names in your performance calculations. So I'm going to come right into the subroutine here called actual performance calculation equations, and I'm going to enter my calculation. Now I want to make my Fahrenheit tag equal to the conversion equation using my Celsius tag. So what I'm going to do is start off by typing BA underscore, and at this point I usually press Control J on the keyboard, and that does two things for me. One, it tells me what the variable is and I don't have to type, and it makes sure I'm using the correctly declared word or phrasing, and second, it eliminates typos in the variable name, so I like to use that. So I need to set that variable or that tag's value equal to an equation that's going to convert my Celsius tag's value. And what I've done is I have got a conversion equation. I've just simply looked it up on the web and pasted it in here. And what I need to do is replace this Celsius variable with the value from my Celsius tag. So I need to phrase this so Visual Basic is going to know what I'm talking about. So I want to multiply 9/5 times the tag name plus 32. So I will begin typing my tag name, use my IntelliSense dot value, and when I'm all done with that line and hit enter, if I don't see any values in red or I don't see anything, any weird squiggly lines, I know I've done it correctly. I'll show you an example. If I wouldn't have put the multiplication symbol in there, I would have gotten a compile error. So I need to make sure that all of my phrasing is correct. And so once you generate the code, you're ready for your next step. Many people consider step 4 of the ACE application or the process of building a calculation as the debugging step. Now, the equation I'm using here is fairly simple. I don't really foresee the need for extensive debugging and stepping through my equation. We will do that in a later example. However, for this case, I'm going to leave the debugging for the future. And in this case, I could select PyACEWizard and debug, and it would step me through and allow me to debug this particular module. Again, we'll see that a little bit later. I don't foresee the need to debug a very simple multiplication calculation here. Step 5 is where we test and compile our code. To do this, you select Add-ins, PyACEWizard, and Test. This will bring up the dialog box where it's asking you to specify a module to test. I'm going to use my first calc module in order to test. And what you're going to see is a list of your input aliases and output aliases, very similar to the way they were defined earlier. And what we can do is a couple different things here. We can either get the current values for all the tags, which would get the current values for our input tags. We could use the typical value as defined in the database. However, most people don't elect to use typical value in their calculations, but you can. I'm going to use the current value, and I'm going to select calculate now. And if your calculation runs correctly, what you'll see in the output aliases under current value is a number or a string or whatever output your calculation should be outputting. In our case, it is the Fahrenheit value of the BA temp 1 tags Celsius current value, and I can see that I do have a current value and that it does seem correct. You can also select the advanced test button, and this allows you to use various input values like the minimum value, a maximum value, bad value, typical value, or current value, and you can run these tests based on the various input settings. So it's a little bit more advanced way to to do this test, and it does report the different metrics here. You can see I've used the number of points that were 5, and the percent good was 440, and my interval size was 10. So it does run some various test results. You can use any specific reference time that you want to use, and if you did use multiple contexts, you could change the context here as well. You have the choice of printing or returning to the previous menu. Once I get the test, the calculate now, to run to my satisfaction, I usually will close out and move on to the next step. Once you've successfully completed a test of your calculation and you are happy or satisfied with the results of that test, you can go and do the final step with the ACE module, and you can register it. The register allows you to do two things. It actually creates the calculation for the scheduler, and it allows you to set the scheduling, and this is very important. I want to talk about this. First, I'm going to select the priority. This is the priority given to the process from the system, and it's a good idea to set this as normal. It's usually best so you don't interrupt other critical processes that are running at the operating system level. For scheduling, we have a choice of clock or natural, and it's they're very self-explanatory methodologies. In the clock methodology, I set a period of how many seconds, minutes, or hours as the interval that I want to run the calculation. And if I wanted to offset that from the top of the hour or the top of the minute or top of the day, I could do that here. So for example, if I wanted to run this calculation every 5 minutes, I could set this to 5 minutes and put an offset of 0 minutes, and that would make sure it ran at the top of the hour, and then 5 after the hour, 10 after the hour, 15 after the hour, and so on. If this was something similar to a shift calculation, I might set the period to 8 hours, and if my shift started at 6:30, I could offset it by 6.5 hours, and that way I would do the calculation once at shift change every 8 hours, beginning at 6:30 in the morning and continuing on through the day. Now, for my tag, I don't want to use the clock. What I want to do is use the natural method. And what the natural method does is it uses a snapshot event trigger as the trigger for the calculation. So what you're presented with when you select natural is the list of input tags that were declared in the initial phase of your wizard. I only had one input tag, so it's only showing me one tag. And when I select that tag, what that's telling ACE is that whenever that tag gets a new value in the snapshot subsystem to perform the ACE calculation. So I'm using the actual input tags, snapshots, as triggers for the ACE calculation and thus the output. So what's going to occur here when I select this tag is that every time va_temp.1 gets a value, it's going to create the calculation and write a value to my output tag. You can see I got a message that says it was registered successfully. I click OK and I can close this. My ACE calculation is done. I don't need to do anything else with the development environment.